So friends, here we are. We are ready to start this new amazing live event covering the October total lunar eclipse. And I just started the live feed, and I just would like to know if you are listening and hearing me correctly before officially starting this. I see that the audio is coming fine, the video as well, but I hope that some friends on the chat can actually confirm that everything is running and that they can listen to me correctly, friends. I can easily see, but still want. So we are going to start soon images of this live event. I'm receiving great pictures from my all around the globe. Okay, I see that people are receiving me correctly, so I'm very happy to start this live coverage. Welcome aboard. That is Gianluca Masi from the Virtual Telescope Project in Italy. I'm very happy and proud to share with you this new big event that is the total lunar eclipse happening today. And we are going to share wonderful images coming from different continents. This is the only event on this planet right now gathering images from New Zealand, Australia, and other countries as the United States, Panama, Costa Rica, and Canada. So we are really international here, and no other in the world is doing this right now. This event will be both in English and Italian because the Virtual Telescope is hosted in Italy and we have a large audience, Italian audience, so I will try to go back and forth between English and Italian. Images are already coming, and I will be happy to share one image with you right now through this video because people is asking that they want to see something here, and of course this is easily for me to be done. And here it is, the first image I would like to share with you, making possible to enjoy such a very event. This image is coming from John Johnson from Nebraska, USA, and from here I will officially start everything. Now I'm going to send some greetings to the Italian audience. And but before, I want to remind you that this event is hosted in partnership with a few technological partners of the Virtual Telescope Project. They are Unitor Italia Instruments, Software BISC, Badr Planetarium, Santa Barbara Instruments Group, and Planewave Instruments, as well as the most important press agency in Italy, ANSA, in particular the Scientific and Technological Department. And for this, I wish to thank my friend and colleague, Dottoressa Enrica Battifoglia. That's all. Let me say something to the Italian friends, and we will start enjoying this event. Dunque, buongiorno, benvenuto, il benvenuto vi viene da Gianluca Masi del progetto Virtual Telescope che anche oggi torna a mostrare le meraviglie del cielo e lo fa in grande stile con uno dei più grandi eventi internazionali che francamente si siano mai visti. Dal momento che a questa diretta della splendida eclissi di ottobre contribuisce un team che ricopre di fatto quasi tutto il pianeta, dalla Nuova Zelanda all'Australia, agli Stati Uniti d'America, a Panama, al Canada, a Costa Rica. Dunque una copertura che non ha eguali, senza precedenti e che e speranzosamente ci permetterà di avere maggiori speranze di cielo sereno. A dire il vero, le immagini stanno già arrivando dai nostri collaboratori. Io sono dunque pronto a iniziare a mostrarle, a condividerle, a commentarle insieme. Ricordo che il progetto Virtual Telescope ha come partner tecnologici importanti Uniton Italia Instruments, Software BISC, Badra Planetarium, Santa Barbara Instruments Group e Planewave Instrument, e che questo evento è organizzato in collaborazione con ANSA, in particolare la redazione scientifica, e per questo ringrazio la dottoressa Enrica Battifoglia. Siamo dunque pronti e direi che possiamo iniziare a condividere la prima immagine ottenuta da John Johnson dal Nebraska, che mostra già avanzata la fase parziale dell'eclissi. L'evento si terrà sia in lingua italiana che in lingua inglese, ci sono davvero molte migliaia di utenti connessi in questo momento da mezzo mondo, devo dire, sicché faremo del nostro meglio per, come dire, portare la Luna a tutti coloro che ci stanno seguendo in questo momento. So we started, as you can see, and I just want to show you another image coming this time from a different country. Let me see if I can go with this. We were seeing images from Nebraska now, that is in the United States, but let's jump to Australia right now. And I have a great image coming from there, and I really want to show it to you. I must say that running this event is quite hard because I am receiving images from many different places in the world, of course, and I have to, of course, to arrange them so that they can show correctly, and this is why it is taking a few seconds for doing this. But trust me, this is something without any precedent similar event, because as I said, we are just receiving images from all the planet. And the image I'm going to show you is coming from, as I said, from Australia. And let me show this one, because it is truly, truly wonderful. The image is coming in a few seconds, just making available. Please understand that in order to see at the best, I suggest you to be on the Virtual Telescope webpage, because from there you can even save JPEG images and share them, if you like, on your social media and whatever, so that you can save some of those images. People I know are generally happy doing that, so here we are. This image is now coming, as I said, from Australia. I want to show you the image to you. Just give me a chance to upload it, because this is truly, truly wonderful. And here it is, the new image, and hope that you are enjoying it very much. This coming is from Dean Hooper, Australia. So from the United States, we really jumped in a different part of the globe, that is Australia, and enjoy this amazing sight. The image we are receiving right now is coming, as I said, from Australia, so I hope that you also enjoy this different perspective. Dopo il primo scatto, la prima abbiamo iniziato la diretta, che proveniva appunto dagli Stati Uniti continentali, dal Nebraska, dalla città di Omaha, qui ci troviamo invece a spiare la Luna, idealmente dall'Australia. Dean Hooper ci invia questa splendida realizzazione che noi siamo ben lieti di condividere. Avrei anche desiderio di condividere ancora un'altra immagine, che stavolta proviene dalla Nuova Zelanda, e a inviarcela è Mirko Arnish. E allora ho desiderio di aggiungere anche a questa copertura un altro continente. Devo dire che questa joint venture in così internazionale è davvero senza precedenti, e auspico che tutto questo possa essere proprio di vostro maggiore gradimento. Suggerisco, per una visione ideale, di stare direttamente proprio sulla pagina web, senza ingrandire la schermata di YouTube, perché in questo modo potrete anche ricevere e salvare le immagini in JPEG dalla porzione sottostante del monitor. Aggiungiamo dunque l'immagine, che neozelandese, giusto un istante, Ed eccola qui. Mirko Arnish, New Zealand, ci spedisce questa splendida realizzazione appunto della fase parziale. So, the eclipse is going, this is a total eclipse, meaning that at some point, soon actually, the moon will be entirely inside the shadow of the earth. There is a perfect alignment between the sun, that is the light source, the earth, sending its shadow to the moon, and the moon itself. And I just wanted to make clear that you understand what is happening. Here it is, what is happening. And right now, the moon is already inside, partially inside the shadow of the earth. And this graphic, I believe, is making things really, really clear. At some point, when the shadow will reach the other border of the moon itself will be completely inside the earth shadow and the eclipse will start to be total. The red color you will see is due to the light arriving to the moon, no matter the presence, the obstacle of the earth, because from the moon, during totality, you will see the earth surrounded by the atmosphere, a red atmosphere, because the red is the color reaching the moon. And to make this even clear, here it is an image I would like to show. This is a quite rare image. Imagining on the bottom to stay on the moon right now during the different phases, and you can see what is happening. Questa, dicevo, è un'eclissi totale. La luna si immerge completamente all'interno dell'ombra della Terra e lo farà tra poco, quando appunto sarà l'ombra arrivata sul bordo opposto rispetto a quello da cui aveva iniziato a coprire il disco lunare, e quando arriverà al culmine ci aspettiamo, come sempre, di vedere la luna di color bronzo, dal momento che, pur nascosta la luce del sole, dalla luna si vedrebbe comunque l'atmosfera terrestre, quasi come un'aureola rossastra, bronza appunto, perché il colore rosso quello che l'atmosfera fa arrivare, separandola a mo' di prisma, fino appunto alla Luna. Ecco, questa immagine, a mio parere, illustra davvero molto molto bene come accade questa colorazione, il perché di questo colore caratteristico. Mentre ovviamente qui abbiamo la possibilità anche di apprezzare la geometria, che poi è alla base, dicevo, della formulazione dell'eclissi. Un allineamento perfetto tra Sole, Terra e Luna, che fa sì che in questa direttrice quasi esatta, sostanzialmente, la Luna si infili precisamente dentro l'ombra della Terra. Siccome l'immersione è completa, l'eclissi sarà giustamente totale. Torniamo però alle immagini ottenute finora. We are back to the images we obtained so far, and others are coming. I must say that our friends are doing a great job, and by the way, I would like to remind you who is taking part to this amazing event. They are Dean Hooper from Australia, John Stevenson, Australia, Chris Stockdale, Australia, Joachim Fabrica Polleri, Panama, Gary Barney in Florida, United States, Fernando Rodriguez, again Florida, United States, James McHugh, New Mexico, United States, Malcolm Park, Toronto, Canada, Bill Longo, Toronto, Canada, Ron Delvaux, Arizona, United States, John Johnson, Nebraska, United States, Marci Malavasi, Costa Rica, and Mirko Arnish, New Zealand. As you can see, basically we have three continents at least, including also at this point Europe, from where I'm talking. I'm in Rome, and you can see that this is truly a global event. But it is time for me to check if we have some more images coming. I think so, because I see that there is always new images coming. And now I want to show you an image by James McHugh, working in New Mexico. Some of the observers are constantly reporting the weather, because they have not good weather, and I want to share with you an image from New Mexico by James McHugh, and let me just work to have the image available. It has just arrived, of course, and let me see if I can just adjusted the images for what is needed. Here it is. And you will see this nice shot by, as I say, James McHugh, observing from New Mexico in the United States. Going to share the image with you. Just a handful of seconds. I'm really amazed and I still want to underline you that what you are seeing is live. Images are coming from those remote locations. They are sent to the Virtual Telescope facility in Italy, and once received, they are just scaled to fit the needs, the parameters needed for this live broadcasting, and then the images are arriving. And here it is, the image we received by James McHugh from New Mexico. Going to add it as well to the live video, and here it is, friends. Enjoy this other image by James McHugh. But images are still coming, and I hope that you are truly having fun and enjoying all what is happening here. I must say that this is the second eclipse happening, total lunar eclipse, I mean, happening this year, and we will have actually four eclipses in a row, four total eclipses in a row. So this is the second, and the other two ones will be, of course, next year. Hopefully you are really enjoying all this. We have a lot of people connected from many different places around the globe, and I still want to update the images. Our imagers worldwide are truly doing an amazing job. Here it is, another great image I'm just received by John Johnson, Nebraska. A few of the observers are having troubles with the weather, but they are there facing the weather, ready to take images, so I really want to thank everybody. Siamo pronti a mostrare un'altra splendida immagine che giunge di nuovo dal Nebraska, da John Johnson, che la invia in tempo reale alla sede operativa qui a Roma del progetto Virtual Telescope, immagine che ormai comincia già a colorarsi con le splendide tinte che tutti amiamo vedere, appunto, della totalità. Ecco l'immagine che ritengo sia decisamente spettacolare. Il tempo solo, come sempre, di renderla disponibile online e di lasciare al sistema la possibilità, appunto, di aggiornarsi. Naturalmente propongo anche attraverso il canale di YouTube. Here it is, another image coming again from Omaha, Nebraska, from John Johnson, showing that we are very close to the final total phase of the eclipse. And the red hue is already apparent, the bronze color is going to show pretty well. All these images are great. And as I said, please remember that the many observers are making this possible. You just hear me, but please believe that all those observers are doing a very precious work. Without them, we would have no images. And even those actually under the clouds are doing what they can to spy the weather, to monitor it, and they are ready to capture images should the clouds open at some point. Here it is, another beautiful image from I have to say that there are many of them. I want to show you an image now coming from Bill Longo, again from Canada. Some of these images are referring to a few minutes ago, but it is nice also because this way you have even a more dynamical evidence of the changes of the moon while the eclipse evolves. So I really hope that you are enjoying all this. Let me see if I can show you this one. Okay. This is a very nice image by coming from Canada. I love the way the Virtual Telescope is working, showing all this to the world, because the eclipse is invisible from Europe and Africa and part of Asia, while all the other continents are, I would say, luckily enough to hopefully see the eclipse, but I see that in the United States there are some troubles with the weather. Here it is an image coming from Bill Longo, and I want to show that images too through the YouTube video. Just wait for a few seconds. Una nuova immagine che arriva stavolta dal Canada, da Bill Longo, che cattura la fase parziale, che come vediamo è comunque si sta evolvendo. Tenete presente che tra queste immagini possono esserci differenze di qualche minuto, però è anche affascinante alle volte con uno scatto fare un piccolo passo indietro, perché questo con maggiore dinamismo forse evidenzia proprio come nel giro di pochi minuti, ora che l'eclissi è prossima a culminare nella totalità, siano dei cambiamenti davvero davvero notevoli. Desidero ovviamente sempre ringraziare e ricordare il contributo importante che i nostri partner stanno davvero offrendoci, proprio perché stiamo osservando da luoghi che sono remoti, e noi qui dall'Europa, dall'Italia in particolare, avremmo certamente perduto questa eclissi se non fosse stato per la loro disponibilità ad aderire a questa importante copertura in diretta organizzata dal progetto Virtual Telescope. Sottolineo che si tratta di una delle più imponenti partecipazioni internazionali mai tentate, proprio perché, come ho ripetuto, qui sono coinvolti almeno tre continenti nell'acquisizione delle immagini, cui si aggiunge ovviamente anche la collocazione italiana come centro di coordinamento. Una splendida immagine ci giunge ora da Christoph Dale, mi chiedo scusa, dall'Australia, che merita una condivisione immediata, cosa che mi appresto a fare istantaneamente. An image has just arrived from Australia, sent by Chris Stockdale, and I'm going to make this image available to you right away, also on the video, and you will see how the totality is now really approaching soon, and I will also show to you the times of this eclipse in a few seconds. Here it is, the new image showing almost the totality, beautifully captured by Chris Stockdale. All this happening live thanks to the Virtual Telescope project, and I really hope that you are enjoying this titanic effort. Trust me when I say that this truly is a titanic effort, friends. Amazing. I'm really always captured by the fantastic elegance of these natural events, and I want to share with you some details about the eclipse. Here they are. As you can see, the totality is going to start in a few minutes, and I hope that we will have a very nice bronze elegant moon. I apologize for the tone of my voice, but I have a strong cold, the first consequence of the new fall season here in Italy. But back to the moon, we want to see the moon. Here you saw where the eclipse is visible and where not. Europe and Africa and the Middle East are under the sun right now, so the moon is not visible, and of course even the eclipse is not visible. Here we are back to the image we received by Chris Stockdale, and I want to check and see if we have more. I see that we are continuously receiving images. Another beautiful shot from John Johnson, Nebraska, and it is funny for me, a bit crazy, I must say, just receiving so many images, adjusting them, but I'm truly excited because of the fantastic sights we are having thanks to our many collaborators. And I still want to thank all of them. Please prepare to something special now that you will see this new image by John Johnson, Nebraska. Because here you have now the flavor of the total phase. Be ready, this is something you will really enjoy. And hopefully this is making well worthwhile for you to be here tracking the virtual telescope. As I said, you can save the image by clicking on it on the bottom. That is a normal JPEG image, JPG image, ready for you to be shared on your network, on your social media. And I welcome you doing that. Please just indicate there that this image is coming from the live event provided for free by the Virtual Telescope Project. Time for us to add now a new image, the one I promised to be fantastic by my good friend John Johnson in Nebraska. I'm just making it available also on the video. The image is already available below. Una nuova immagine che cattura ormai di fatto quasi la totalità, di nuovo dal Nebraska, John Johnson, che rende giustizia assoluta alla meraviglia dell'eclissi. È davvero spettacolare rendersi conto di come in un momento come questo, pur visto magari molte volte da chi ci segue, si rimane senza ombra di dubbio rapiti da qualcosa di straordinario. I will say that this image now is one of the best we have received so far, also thanks to the clue of the eclipse coming right now. All the people here are doing such a very fantastic job. Just writing an update on our social media. Here we are. What a wonderful shot, I must say. Needless to say, this is breathtaking. And I really hope that you are having fun with us, thanks to the tireless work done by our collaborators everywhere in the world. Now going to check if we have something new. Again, I have other images. They are coming continuously thanks to such a wonderful, great team. And let me see what we have available. I want to share another image of Mirko Arnisch, referring to the partial phase, and it will be a striking contrast, as I said, what the totality can do with the moon. So let me show this image from New Zealand by Mirko. They are really doing a fantastic job. Without them, without our friends everywhere on this planet taking images for us, we were going to really miss this eclipse. Ecco la nuova immagine che giunge di nuovo dalla Nuova Zelanda, ci porta qualche minuto indietro, ma sottolinea in effetti la straordinaria variazione che la Luna subisce quando ormai è prossima alla fase totale. Eccola qui, è bellissimo anche vedere come nel buio apparente dei dintorni della Luna si noti poi la presenza di quell'ultimo lembo che sopravvive ancora, fuori dall'ombra del nostro pianeta, ma è solo questione di istanti evidentemente e poi scomparirà, come poi in effetti abbiamo visto assieme nell'immagine che giungeva dal Nebraska. Ecco, è anche affascinante appunto accostarle queste immagini, cosa che poi evidentemente faremo, perché rendono ancora miglior giustizia alla capacità, se vogliamo, estetica della Luna, inconsapevole ovviamente, di regalarci simili visioni e un simile spettacolo. We have new images, and we entered formally now the totality. I want to share images I received right now, a wonderful image I received by Chris Stockdale, coming right away to you. Just as you have seen, I just need to adjust a few things before sharing, because every observer is sending images with a different format depending on the instruments she or he is using, of course. But for me, it is such a privilege to show all this and enjoy this just the perfect sight we have received by, again from Australia, by Chris Stockdale. This is showing back the totality, something amazing. Here it is, the image. We are ready to show another totality image, as I said, received by Chris Stockdale in Australia, and I'm pleased to share this again through the Virtual Telescope project website. Happy that you are having fun. I am receiving many comments of people saying thank you, and I will forward this thank you to the imagers doing for us all this possible. Here it is, the new image by Chris, wonderfully capturing the totality. And enjoy the amazing beauty of the eclipse itself. Then I have other images, again from Australia. Sorry, the New Zealand, sent by Mirko Arnish, making clear also how the moon is now getting more difficult to see. And while this image, the one I'm just sharing, is not showing the color, it is just showing, maybe in a more natural way, how the moon changed its brightness from being a blinding strong light to almost dark with a naked eye. And here it is, the image, please enjoy, from Mirko Arnish. Here it is, and also I want to add this other image to our video. All those images are fantastic, and I also want to thank those who are silently monitoring their local weather. But so far we are receiving amazing shots. Here it is, another one, friends. What beautiful images we are receiving. I'm truly amazed. Another image of the totality received from John, Nebraska, Omaha. Going to share it right away to you. Un'altra immagine che ci riporta nel pieno della totalità, appena ricevuta da John Johnson in Nebraska, che mostra davvero una luna meravigliosa. Eccola qui, giusto il tempo di sistemare l'immagine. Questa che ora apparirà, sono certo, genererà una esclamazione di meraviglia in tutti coloro che la vedranno. Eccola, il sistema tra poco ve la proporrà aggiornata. Auspico che l'evento sia di vostro gradimento e ora la condivido anche attraverso la piattaforma video. I'm going to share another amazing image received by John Johnson in Nebraska. All the observers are doing a fantastic job, and here John captured basically the totality in a wonderful way. Congratulations for such a beautiful shot. And enjoy, my friends. This is simply amazing. Simply amazing, I believe. I don't know what we can say when facing such a very, very beautiful. Nature is always able to shock us with its beauty, and this image by John really captured all this in a wonderful natural way. But we are still running, the eclipse is just approaching the very center, the magic moment. And I have here now an image coming from James McHugh from New Mexico, and going to share his sight with you. Wonderful, wonderful job. It's also nice for me to show how different observers, different instruments, different sights are actually adding something to the experience, you know. There are clouds also in New Mexico, from where our friend James is working, but I want to show this wonderful image. He captured the spider clouds, and here it is for you, my friends, just saving it right away and share it in almost real time. Okay, and now going to add this as well to the YouTube live feed. I also want to thank space.com for featuring this event, as well as Sky and Telescope and the Universe Today for hosting, I would say, the news about this live coverage, and thanks to them we were able to reach a larger, wonderful international audience. Ecco una nuova immagine che giunge or ora dal Nebraska, che mostra ancora meglio la fase totale. Ricordo che proprio in questo periodo il Virtual Telescope, che è un progetto che trasmette, come vedete, in diretta gratuitamente per tutti le bellezze dell'universo, ha lanciato una campagna di autofinanziamento. Noi non abbiamo nessun supporto istituzionale, il progetto sopravvive grazie, devo dire, ai sacrifici economici di chi vi parla e al contributo di poche persone che decidono, attraverso la volontaria donazione, di permetterci di andare avanti. Dicevo, proprio 2 settimane fa all'incirca abbiamo lanciato una campagna di crowdfunding proprio per acquisire un nuovo dispositivo d'immagine col quale contiamo di fare, se possibile, meglio di quanto fatto negli ultimi 8 anni, 8 anni che hanno visto il progetto Virtual Telescope raggiungere ben 6 milioni di persone in oltre 230 paesi, di fatto rendendolo il più efficiente, operativo e seguito progetto di questo tipo al mondo, ribadisco, senza budget alcuno. Ma per sopravvivere abbiamo bisogno di un piccolo aiuto e chi vuole può farlo affidandosi alla sua sensibilità e generosità attraverso il link che vede riportato da più parti sul nostro sito. E in particolare, dicevo, abbiamo lanciato alla metà di settembre questa campagna per raccogliere una somma media importante per acquisire un nuovo strumento che renderà il Virtual Telescope assolutamente superiore rispetto all'eccellenza che già manifesta nel condividere l'universo gratuitamente con tutti. Chiunque volesse contribuire è davvero benvenuto, sapendo che aiuta il progetto in qualcosa che altrimenti non potrebbe fare. I have a wonderful image I was really hoping to receive, and it is coming from Bill Longo, because if you look, for example, here at the map showing where the moon is right now, you can see that there is a planet Uranus there, of course, in the same field of view. And now I would like to try to capture and show this planet, as I have an image where likely the object is visible. Let me see, let me check. I'm just trying to figure where. Let me share this image first of all, as received from Canada by Bill Longo. Here it is. Okay. I'm just adjusting the image, a bit more complex than the previous ones, but hope that it is rewarding. Look at this wonderful image we received by Bill Longo in Canada, coming to you soon. Okay. Uploading. And then also sharing it via our video feed. Hope that you are liking it. Here it is, by Bill. I just was doing some checks to see if there was something. Just 1 second, please. Okay. I really hope that you are having some very good sight. Wonderful, isn't it, friends? And you can see there is Uranus there. and I really hope that you are enjoying this site, friends. Fantastic, amazing. What a wonderful experience we are all having here. We have thousands of people joining, and this image is truly, truly amazing, I believe. I hope that you are truly enjoying. This is something I really love to share in real time with people. But still, new images are arriving, and I want to show all of them to you. Now we are really approaching the central eclipse, and this image again from Nebraska is outstanding. Here it is. Adjusting the image from John Johnson, Nebraska, showing the spectacular moon we are facing right now, of course. Ed eccola in tutta bellezza la nuova immagine che ci arriva da John Johnson, dal Nebraska. The new image is coming soon. Enjoy the beautiful color of the moon during the totality. This is amazing, friends. Amazing, I believe. Here it is. Just adjusting and coming in a handful of seconds. Here it is to you. Wonderful, isn't it? Splendida, che cattura la totalità in tutta la sua bellezza. I have another image coming from Australia, from Dean, making a great job there as well. So we have really great people doing a fantastic job sharing the wonders of such an eclipse with the world. So we are very, very grateful to this fantastic, I would say, this dream team, including also those under the clouds, because they really were there ready to make what they could do, but sometimes the weather is stronger than our, I will say, desire to look at this wonderful stuff. And here it is, a wonderful image by Dean Hooper, Australia, and sharing it with you once again. I'm truly impressed to see how the eclipse never fails shocking us with its beauty. Here it is, the image from Dean Hooper, adding now it as well to our live feed collection. And from Nebraska, United States, we jump in a second to Australia, where Dean is, in Melbourne area, Victoria. So from Nebraska, USA, we jump to Victoria, Australia. and look at this very beautiful sight provided by Dean. Just amazing, my friends. I believe that this is something you will never forget. Hopefully all this is just giving you some fantastic experience. I wish to thank all for making this possible. Something truly amazing, friends. Amazing, to say the least. So far, really tens of thousands of people looked and are still looking to the eclipse thanks to our service. The virtual telescope is rocking thanks to the many friends. And I want to remind you that the virtual telescope project is a volunteer project without any funding, and you are welcome to support us by donations, because without those few people supporting us by donations, the virtual telescope will die in a few days. We launched recently, by the way, an important fundraising campaign, a crowdfunding campaign, in order to buy a new CCD camera, making possible for the virtual telescope to show even better the universe to people worldwide. All our events are free, but of course what is free does not mean that it has no costs. And when I can, I cover the cost myself, but this time for this we need your help. Many people contributed, and I hope that enjoying these things we share with you for free, you will decide to support by donations. And you can see on the website several places where the donation option is made available. Please join this important campaign. I'm very grateful to you for this. And I would like just to show why images are still coming. We are approaching the very central totality. I would like to just to show you again how all this evolved while we were observing. Not too bad at all. What a wonderful coverage we did so far from New Zealand, Australia, United States and Canada, making this the largest international event ever, with such a huge, also geographically speaking, cooperation. And this event, as all the events that Virtual Telescope has hosted, that also thanks to the technological partners we have, Uniton Italia Instruments, Software BISC, Badr Planetarium, Santa Barbara Instruments Group, and Planewave Instruments. And this event is a joint cooperation with ANSA Scienza e Tecnica, the scientific team, and I want to thank them as well. You can really enjoy the beauty of this eclipse thanks to our images. I must say that having the cold soon after the summer is not the best, but I could not miss this event and live comment we are sharing. Ecco una panoramica riassuntiva di fatto delle immagini ottenute finora. Desidero precisarlo, l'eclissi è ancora in corso, ci stiamo avviando giusto proprio alla fase centrale, e è tempo anche di controllare ancora le nuove immagini che arrivano costantemente dal team del Virtual Telescope. I have a very special all sky shot done by Mirko Harnisch that shows the beautiful side of the southern sky. This is a truly amazing bonus, and for this I wish to thank a lot Mirko. You will truly enjoy this with the moon just eclipsed on the bottom part of the image. This is a truly unique image. Thank you so much Mirko for providing it from New Zealand. This one is truly amazing, friends. Enjoy this one. And coming soon also to the live video feed. La prossima immagine ci arriva dalla Nuova Zelanda, grazie a Mirko Harnish, e mostra una visione a tutto cielo con un obiettivo fisheye, dove si riconosce in basso il disco occultato della Luna, ma la magnifica visione del cielo australe con le nubi di Magellano e la Via Lattea è davvero impagabile. You can see easily the Milky Way and the large and small Magellanic Cloud. This is a wonderful sight we received from New Zealand. And thank you, Mirko, for providing such a stunning picture. And Dean is reporting that the last picture we saw earlier from him was a lucky shot, just in a lucky gap in the cloud, and that is how astronomy works. But we have here also another image, amazing image from John Johnson, so far apparently having the best among our collaborators, but still enjoying the large field of view image we received by Mirko from New Zealand. Ed ecco il nuovo splendido scatto che riceviamo dal Nebraska, da John Johnson. Subito condivisa in tempo reale un'ultima immagine, ancora da John Johnson. Abbiamo letteralmente migliaia e migliaia di utenti connessi in questo momento da tutto il mondo, nel corso di questa splendida diretta che ci sta regalando, francamente, immagini indimenticabili dell'eclissi di Luna. Auspico che per tutti sia davvero una grande esperienza. Ed ecco la nuova immagine di John Johnson che cattura mirabilmente ancora la totalità. Here it is, again, a wonderful picture from Nebraska, where John Johnson is really doing a great job, and I think that this one is simply amazing, friends. I have a special image coming from Billungo, Canada, which is truly spectacular because the moon is setting at his location in Canada, but look how beautiful this goodbye to the moon is in this fantastic shot we just received. I'm just trying to adjust. Okay. And I hope that you will truly like this stunning picture by Bill, saying from Canada goodbye to this fantastic eclipse. And we thank a lot Bill for providing some truly fantastic images. I'm just uploading this wonderful picture. Here it is in real time. And now going to show it as well. Wonderful sight, amazing, really. Meanwhile, I have the totality captured again in a wonderful master way by John Johnson. Preparing it while we are all enjoying the wonderful postcard from the moon we received by Bill Long in Canada. Meanwhile, I'm just preparing for the other stupendous shot by John. And here we are. Okay. This is the new image, capturing the maximum of the eclipse right now, basically. Lot of images, lot of unforgettable images. Nuova immagine che cattura la totalità dopo questa splendida cartolina con la luna che scivola nel mezzo della totalità dietro gli alberi della postazione in Canada di Billongo. Ecco, nuova visione della totalità da John Johnson in Nebraska. Ringrazio continuamente e con sincerità i collaboratori del Virtual Telescope che in questo momento da diversi continenti stanno rendendo possibile questa diretta. I wish to thank once again those making possible for us to have such a fantastic coverage. I'm really amazed to see how many people is jumping into this live event thanks to our coverage. No other is showing this involving so very far observers from different continents. This is a truly international, I would say, global experience. I'm so happy that all this is happening now, thanks to the Virtual Telescope project. New images are coming, let's check them. I also want to share an image by Malcolm Park in Canada, who is in a remote place without connection on its laptop, and he has been sharing images by imaging the monitor of the computer, just to let you know how our friends are really willing to share with you what they are seeing. Let me take an image so that I can share it with you. Okay, just putting it on the monitor. This is a nice image from Malcolm Park in Canada. As I said, he had to image the monitor of the computer because he's in a very remote place and it has not enough internet power for this, but I wish to thank him because despite this, he decided to share this experience with us live. And this image is also showing planet Uranus, I believe. And but I want to share this with you. Here it is, and also I want to add it to the live feed. What a wonderful event, what a rush, but truly amazing. And here it is, the image by Malcolm Park, Canada, showing the moon taken through the monitor of his computer because of the poor internet connection at its very remote place. But despite this, through the mobile, he was able to share this. Amazing work, Malcolm, really. Malcolm had a wonderful participation with previous events, and I want to thank for being with us again this time, no matter the difficult condition from such a remote place. Thank you so much, Malcolm. I just wanted to check one thing, if I can. Let's see. Truly outstanding experience. And I just want to see if I can show you something in real time. Okay. Not bad at all, looking at the clips from your home, if you are in Europe, Africa, whatever, wherever the eclipse is not visible, but still we have images coming. I'm just trying to figure if to see if we have a chance to see Uranus. I believe that it is somewhere here, but I need to check better. I'm sorry, of course. This is not astronomical, but as I said, I'm not feeling very good. But let me see if we can have another image. Let me see if we received more shots. I have a very beautiful image from Chris Stockdale. Going to share it live with you. You all are doing such an amazing job, friends. I'm so grateful for you, to you, and I believe that all virtual telescopes are so happy and grateful to you for providing such an amazing experience. And this is fantastic image coming from Chris Stockdale, again from Australia. Making it available now. Okay, friends. Here it is. I'm going to share this image as well with you. Wonderful, from Christoph Dale, Australia. And here it is. Wonderful image. Enjoy, friends. Hope that you are truly having fun with us. I love how we are just sharing all these things. Now new images coming, I see. John Stevenson is sending an image through the moon, but it is a spectacular sight, I must say, with a flu effect due by the clouds. Just adjusting it from John Stevenson, Australia. And here it is, the image by John. Just uploading it for you. Here it is, the image. Through the clouds, from Australia again, John Stevenson. I have also the last image from James McHugh, as he writes, before to be obscured by clouds. So going to share it with you. James, once again, you did such a wonderful work despite the clouds. And here it is, his image. Like as in the image from John, here again you see the moon through the clouds, and I'm going to share this as well. Uploading right now, and also putting it on the video. How many images we received, all of them just fantastic. So from Australia, where John Stevenson captured the image you see now, we are going to New Mexico, United States, where James McHugh captured this last image before to be obscured by clouds, as he wrote. What a wonderful job you are doing, friends. Still images coming here. by John. What a wonderful John. What a wonderful job you have been doing, John. Thank you very much for those exquisite images. Ecco una nuova immagine che giunge ancora dal Nebraska, ma abbiamo compreso quali regioni degli Stati Uniti sono state, come dire, benedette da una condizione meteo favorevole. In particolare abbiamo visto il Nebraska, sprazzi il New Mexico, mentre dall'Arizona, dalla Florida, tempo nuvoloso. Idem anche a Panama, da dove operava il nostro grande amico e collaboratore Joaquin Fabrica Polleri, e anche Marci Malavasi dal Costa Rica ha avuto ovviamente nuvole. New image from John Johnson, Nebraska. We understood now that Nebraska was blessed with a wonderful weather. Some clear sky also in New Mexico, where James McHugh was, but clouds were in Arizona, Ron DelVaux, or Florida, where both Gary Varney and Fernando Rodriguez were working. It was cloudy, but also in Panama, where our good friend Joaquin Fabrica Polleri was ready, and the same in Costa Rica with our great cooperator Marci Malavasi was as well facing the sky ready to image. And here we are with another new amazing shot provided by John Johnson, coming live in a handful of seconds to you, friends. Here it is. And at some point, of course, the totality will end, making available this new shot to you. And here it is. I have also an image from Tom Aradin, Brisbane, Australia, kindly sent by Susan Webb, and I want to share this image with you. Wonderful image, I must say. Just making the image by Tom available. Here it is. Wonderful sight by Tom Aradin, Australia. I'm sharing this live with you right now. And also via our video live feed. Here it is for you, for your own. guardando naturalmente alla tabella dei tempi, chiedo scusa, ripropongo l'immagine giustamente. Tra pochi minuti la totalità finirà e si riconosce anche il lembo dal quale verosimilmente riapparirà la luce del sole. Splendida, straordinaria copertura. Ecco, nuovo l'eclissi che ormai si appresta a raggiungere la fase finale. Mentre ancora riceviamo splendide riprese. Nuova immagine da Christoph Dale, new image from Australia by Chris Stockdale. It is funny to see that there are stars occulted by the moon, while the moon slowly moves against the starry background during the totality, making easier also to spot them because the glare of the moon is occult much less than during ordinary full moon, you know. And here it is, another wonderful image of Christoph Dale, Australia. I'm going to share this right now, right away with you. Here it is. We are still inside the totality, going to end technically in a minute or so. Again, another image by Christoph Dale. And also I have a report by Dan Hooper that basically while imaging captured a star going to be occulted in while taking the image. This is another wonderful capture by Dean, and I want to show it to you so that you can even enjoy the star that Dean reported to be occulted immediately after the picture was taken on the right. Wonderful images, friends. What a job you are doing, all of you. And I want to share with you this image by Dean Hooper. With a star disappearing behind the lunar limb, an handful of seconds later, the image was taken, as reported by Dean. And let me share it with you. Wonderful sight again. We are so lucky to have these great astrophotographers taking unforgettable images for us. Look at this image by Dean Hooper, Australia, with a star disappearing at Tower 3 on the border of the moon. This is a night capture, and luckily it was also visible on the image from Christoph Dale at Tower 4. I wanted to back and forth. This is by Chris. You see, at hour 5, basically, there is a star approaching the lunar limb. And from Australia, not far from the same continent as Chris, Dean captured a star going behind the lunar limb. This is a fantastic coincidence showing something happening during the eclipse. John reports that trees started to interfere with the images, but provided such a stunning image with that interference by the trees that it is well worth a look. Sometimes when the moon, you are just taking some of the best pictures you can. Look at this one by John with the trees just showing. Fantastic sight, I must say. Very romantic, likely. Making the image available to you. Here it is. Wonderful friends, making the image also available here on the video feed. With trees eclipsing the eclipsed moon. Amazing shot, I must say. This was not bad at all. I believe you are happy with this. And then again, images. The totality ended basically. A wonderful image again by Dean Hooper. Beautifully capturing the hand of the totality from Australia. John provided from Nebraska a stunning sight of the eclipsed moon disappearing behind the trees while the hand of totality was approaching, and soon after from Australia we have an image showing the hand of totality by Dean Hooper. Going to adjust the image a bit so that we can enjoy the image itself a bit better. Wonderful, wonderful, really wonderful what we have seen so far, thanks to our fantastic astrophotographers who partnered with the Virtual Telescope to cover once again this truly international event. No others were in the condition to provide such a multi-continental coverage. We are so proud that this was possible thanks to our amazing collaborators everywhere in the countries we mentioned, and I will acknowledge each of them soon again. But before, I want to show you the image of the moon at the end of the totality provided by Dean Hooper, Australia, in the Melbourne area, in Victoria. Breathtaking, friends. Splendida immagine ottenuta da Dean Hooper, Australia, che cattura mirabilmente la fine della fase totale, subito dopo che l'altro bellissimo scatto da parte di John Johnson aveva catturato la totalità mentre la Luna si nascondeva dietro gli alberi. Altro scatto bellissimo ancora, pronti a mostrarlo, di Dean Hooper. con ormai evidente il termine della fase totale mirabile. Davvero questa esecuzione. Davvero splendida. A new image from Dean Hooper coming right now is officially showing the end of totality. Here it is. You can see the totality has gone. It is nice to see back and forth the last two images by Dean, showing how in a few minutes the bright border of the moon is bigger and bigger, saying that the totality ended, friends. What an amazing work, my friend. What a job, I must say. Really, I have no words for this fantastic coverage. Another wonderful sight by Christoph Dale, having a larger field of view. I love also how the observers used different instruments, some of them showing a close-up of the moon, some of them showing a larger vision, as we did in April, by the way, and we enjoyed that, and this is really, a good benefit. È interessante anche notare come diversi osservatori abbiano effettivamente adoperato strumenti diversi, al punto che in alcuni si osservava la Luna in dettaglio, un vero e proprio primo piano, mentre in altri prevaleva una visione a largo campo, e questo ci ha permesso ovviamente anche di gradire naturalmente questa diversa copertura. Ecco una splendida immagine che giunge da Chris Stockdale in Australia, che appunto è una visione a grande campo della fine della totalità. The new image just received by Christoph Dale is showing with a larger field of view the end of totality, where part of the moon is now bright again. Here it is for your own enjoyment. Truly amazing experience, I must say. Fantastic coverage, really. What a great job everyone did here. I want to show you a wonderful sight again by Mirko Arnisch with a very large field of view this time. Once again, truly love how the moon is showing so beautifully against such a wonderful starry sky. Here it is, friends. Coming to you via the web. And now it is also arriving through the live feed. Fantastic field of view. Large field of view in this image by Mirko Arnisch in New Zealand. Very nice. Splendida immagine ora a largo campo che giunge dalla Nuova Zelanda, Mirko Harnisch, che con un obiettivo appunto a copertura ampia del cielo ci regala questa vista bellissima delle stelle intorno al disco ancora occultato della Luna, e la condizione di occultamento di eclissi ovviamente rende la Luna molto più debole, permettendo una lunga esposizione capace di mostrare così tante stelle attorno alla Luna che è tecnicamente piena e che dunque solitamente non permetterebbe una simile ripresa. Davvero eccezionale. So we are really approaching now the end of the eclipse, still receiving a few images, friends. But I see that several observers reported that their coverage ended, at least from the US, from the Americas, for the weather or simply because the moon has just gone too low or below the horizon. So all this is just great. I would like to quickly show you what we obtained so far, thanks to the Virtual Telescope project. And I want to kindly remind you that you can support the Virtual Telescope activities. We did this for free. Everything we do online, showing the universe live, is free. But of course, our system is not free to be maintained. I will be happy and to acknowledge those few people who supported and support us by donations. And if you liked what you have seen, please consider the option to contribute to the life of this project. And as you can see from the website, right now we have a dream that is significantly improving the imaging device we use to show the universe to the world for free. But for this we have to afford some amount, okay, that we don't have, because the Virtual Telescope is just a volunteer effort without any financial support by any institution, just donations to pay bill, electricity and so more. But if you like this and you want to see more, please consider supporting us by free donations. In that case, just follow the links spread on the website saying donations, and you can do this, and you can even learn more about the crowdfunding campaign we launched just to support this new project that is buying a new advanced CCD imaging camera for making the experience of the sky for people worldwide for free still more enjoyable and fantastic. Here are images we collected so far, but a few of them are still coming. I see that Dean Hooper is really having wonderful conditions, because in Australia the moon is better placed basically than the US, where it has set already. So I'm preparing a new image by Dean. Here it is, wonderful shot. So friends, really amazing, really, really amazing. Uploading the new image. Ecco che stiamo giusto per caricare un'ultima immagine che giunge dall'Australia, dove la Luna è ancora perfettamente visibile al di sopra dell'orizzonte, a differenza degli Stati Uniti, dove di fatto per molti è già tramontata, o comunque al di sotto di ostacoli più o meno naturali, in primis gli alberi. Ed ecco questa ammirabile visione che giunge da Dean Hooper, Australia. lot of people tracking the end of this event. And really hope that you had fun so far with us. As for me, this has been a very rewarding experience. Thanks to the amazing team we were able to put together. I wish to thank those who decided to support us by donations. If you like what the Virtual Telescope is doing, if you want to see more and better, please consider supporting us by donations, because we really don't have any financial support, and this month has been hard for us to keep running all this public stuff, because as you can easily understand, what is free for you to see is not free for us to offer. We try to do the best for this, but without the support of you liking the project, we cannot survive. So I thank those who supported us so far and those who want to support us by now. It is easy, you can donate whatever you want, and with that help, we can really do much more for the world, sharing the skies. Thank you. Another image from Tom Aradin, Australia. Going to show it to you. Here it is. And sharing the image by Tom. Right now to you, and also via the live feed. We are approaching the end of this live coverage after, lots of time, more than 100 minutes of live coverage, and here it is, the image by Tom. Oh, this is a truly outstanding experience, once again. I really hope that you are having fun. Ci avviamo ormai quasi alla conclusione di questa splendida, indimenticabile diretta che ci ha condotti a esplorare di nuovo dal vero in tempo reale questa splendida eclissi di Luna. Let's see. I have also a nice video provided by Robert Westbrook from New Mexico that I will try to show if I can. Let me see where I actually uploaded it. Okay. More images arriving here. And this one is a video we received, a time lapse from New Mexico. Just arrived by email by Robert Westbrook. I thank him for sending this and hope that you will enjoy. With the moon showing through the clouds while approaching the totality. Nice sight, I must say. And now going to see some other images. Nice shot by Mirko Harnisch again. Here it is, his image. Going to share the image by Mirko Australia now, and soon we will be ending this live coverage actually. Okay, friends, and here it is the image by Mirko coming soon to you. Here it is. And also another image by John Stevenson showing the moon leaving the totality through the clouds. And here it is. Just saving the image by John. Nuova immagine dall'Australia, John Stevenson, che pesca la luna al termine della totalità tra le nuvole che creano questa curiosa apparenza quasi flu dell'immagine, naturalmente. L'immagine è in arrivo. Trasmessa come sempre in diretta dal nostro sistema. Ricordo che il progetto Virtual Telescope sopravvive soltanto grazie al difficile lavoro di volontariato di chi lo ha realizzato. Tra mille difficoltà economiche, e sopravvive grazie al piccolo contributo che qualcuno tra i tantissimi che ci seguono, apprezzando il nostro lavoro per la divulgazione e la visione in diretta di eventi astronomici, decidono appunto di offrire. Laddove questo magari fosse gradito, saremmo ben felici naturalmente. Donazioni, appunto. Le nuvole infine arrivano anche da Dean Hooper in Australia. Cloud finally arrived also above Dean Hooper in Australia. But we received great images and we are also going to hand actually these. And I have an image by Tom Aladdin that I'm going to show you. Here it is. The very end of totality, of course. Yeah. And I will say that we are really going to end the live coverage with this one. What an experience, friends. Truly amazing one. Ed ecco la nuova immagine. Con cui concludiamo la nostra diretta. So friends, I think that we really had such a wonderful coverage, really. And I'm here just to close this live amazing live session. So friends, here we are now going to conclude this unforgettable coverage of the 8th October total lunar eclipse. Gianluca Masi is here thanking you for joining this titanic effort, because it was a titanic effort, actually putting together people from many different countries on this planet. And I apologize if my shape was not the best, but a cold actually it had me yesterday, so I'm not in the best shape, but I wanted to be here again for sharing this wonderful event. All the good that you have seen is just something that we need to say thank to a few people, making possible for us to receive those images in real time. And I want to thank all of them and the astrophotographers who made possible for us to enjoy those stunning images were Dean Hooper, Melbourne, Australia, John Stevenson, Queensland, Australia, Christoph Dale, Victoria, Australia, Joachim Fabrica-Polleri, Panama, Gary Barney, Florida, United States, Fernando Rodriguez, Florida, United States, James McHugh, New Mexico, United States, Malcolm Park, Canada, observing from Minnesota, Bill Longo from Canada, Ron Delvaux from Arizona, United States, John Johnson from Nebraska, United States, Marci Malavasi from Costa Rica e Mirko Arnish from New Zealand. All of them, no matter the weather they had at their location, did a wonderful work, not only today taking images, but also preparing this hard task all the past days. I can easily say that this event was one of the greatest ever hosted online, not only by the Virtual Telescope, but by every live, I would say, facility sharing the cosmos that way, because no others before this were able to put together people from so very different continents, people from New Zealand, Australia, United States, Panama, Costa Rica, and Europe, from where I'm speaking, that is Italy, that is Rome in Italy. So really a giant effort, but let me say that the results were even bigger. We saw very spectacular images, we enjoy close-up of the moon, larger field of view, showing the stars, showing Uranus around, and for me this has been fantastic. So once again, I wish to thank the astrophotographers I have just mentioned earlier, making possible to run this event. This is the poster of the event, hosted at the Virtual Telescope. that is the leading facility sharing the Cosmos live in real time through the internet for free. But to keep this project running, we need your help. Please, if you can, donate to us whatever you want, even the equivalent of a coffee, a beer, a pizza, whatever you want, because without any financial support, as we are just surviving thanks to the hard work and the efforts of myself, basically, and to the support of a few, I would say, people, generous people, donating from time to time something, we could not go longer. And we also have a big project that is improving the quality of our system with a new imaging camera, but for this we have a crowdfunding campaign, and it is, if you can support us by donations, it is time for you to show this support now. And I hope that this way you will enjoy for many other years to come what we did for 8 years now, serving and bringing the universe to 6 million individuals from more than 235 countries worldwide. No others can show this number, and as you know, all this for free from your point of view. So please support and donate to keep alive the virtual telescope. That's all, and once again, thank you to you for coming. Thanks to our astrophotographers for making a wonderful job, and I hope to see again you soon, again on the virtual telescope. Goodbye. Siamo dunque ormai in conclusione. Questo evento ci ha condotti ad osservare l'eclissi di Luna grazie al contributo di astrofotografi sparsi in Australia, Nuova Zelanda, Stati Uniti, Canada, Costa Rica, Panama. Desidero ringraziarli ancora. Essi sono Dan Hooper, Victoria, Australia, John Stevenson, Queensland, Australia, Chris Stocktail, Victoria, Australia, Joaquin Fabrica Polleri, Panama, Gary Varney, Florida, Fernando Rodriguez, Florida, James McHugh, New Mexico, Malcolm Park, Canada, Billongo, Canada, Ron Delvaux, Arizona, John Johnson, Nebraska, Marci Malavasi, Costa Rica e Mirko Arnish, Nuova Zelanda. In quello che è stato l'evento più internazionale che sia mai stato ospitato sulla rete, con un contributo abbiamo visto da luoghi incredibilmente distanti e con la diretta condotta da Roma in Italia attraverso le tecnologie del Virtual Telescope. Virtual Telescope che sopravvive grazie a un'attività di mero volontariato, senza alcun supporto istituzionale, tra mille difficoltà, dal momento che pesa esclusivamente sulle tasche di chi lo ha realizzato e che con amore per la conoscenza e la scienza del cielo condivide gratuitamente tutto questo con chiunque. In questi 8 anni di attività, oltre 6 milioni di utenti da 235 paesi hanno potuto spiare il cielo in diretta a costo zero. Tutto questo grazie al di chi ha assemblato il tutto e al piccolo contributo di chi di tanto in tanto, constatando la validità del progetto, decide di supportarci. Chiunque volesse è benvenuto nel farlo, ne abbiamo davvero bisogno, attraverso il meccanismo della donazione, anche perché abbiamo lanciato proprio da poco un progetto di aggiornamento importante che, se conseguito, permetterà a noi ancora di offrire al meglio la visione del cosmo, di nuovo gratuitamente, con la stessa serietà, la stessa affidabilità che hanno reso leggendaria la reputazione del Virtual Telescope al mondo, schiacciando anche coloro che hanno budget milionari e istituzioni pesanti alle loro spalle. La passione e l'amore per ciò che si fa vincono contro ogni cosa, ma le bollette ci sono e per questo chiediamo il contributo di tutti. Ringrazio naturalmente anche i nostri partner tecnologici, Uniton Italia Instruments, Software BISC, Badr Planetarium, Santa Barbara Instruments Group e Plainview Instruments, e ringrazio anche ANSA Scienza e Tecnica per la partnership nella realizzazione di questo evento. Chi vorrà potrà continuare a seguirci, magari iscrivendosi alla nostra pagina fan The Virtual Telescope Project su Facebook, oppure tutto scrivendo in basso con subscribe appunto gli aggiornamenti dal nostro sito. Mi pare tutto e io vi ringrazio nuovamente, vi auguro una buona giornata, un buon pomeriggio. I wish to thank, of course, the technological partners of the Virtual Telescope. They are Uniton Italia Instruments, Software BISC, Badr Planetarium, Santa Barbara Instruments Group and Plainview Instruments, as well as ANSA Scienza e Tecnica for the joint venture organizing this. And I really hope that you will join us for future events. You can just like our fan page on Facebook, the Virtual Telescope Project, that is the name of the page, or even subscribing the updates from the website, looking on the bottom right of the website itself. I think that is all, and again, thank you for coming here. Thanks a lot to our astrophotographers, and keep looking at the stars. The Virtual Telescope is ready in a few days to show you a close approaching asteroids. Learn more soon. Goodbye, friends.